Okay, das ist voll. So, jetzt kommt noch der Stopfen. Einmal das kleine Tuch. Und der Stopfen. So.
Herzlich willkommen bei whisky.de, dem Treffpunkt feiner Geister. Und heute machen wir Wissenschaft.
Ja, ist leider gar kein Intro, was du jetzt gerade gesprochen hast.
Wieso?
Denn es wird hinter das geschnitten, was ich gemacht habe. Also ich habe schon das Intro gesprochen, das war aber schon gestern. Also es ist ein Tag vergangen, wir sind wieder bei whisky.de in unseren Gefilden. Und das Fass ist angekommen. Und jetzt werde ich euch mal genau erklären, worum es geht. Also das Fass geht zur Lagerung und wir wollen rausfinden, wie färbt sich Whisky während der Lagerung. Und ja, lange Rede, kurzer Sinn. Ich habe das Fass jetzt gleich hier drüben aufgestellt. Dann gehen wir gleich mal in die andere Szene.
Welcome to whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning, and this is my son Ben. And today we have another scientific experiment starting. The last one I had, you find on our website. There's a
Science section.
Science section.
And there's, I think there's only one thing.
There's
in there.
One
it's
in.
It's yours.
Mine, and now it's yours.
Yeah. You did chill frotting. The thing is, this is not actually the beginning of the video. You just did the introduction, but I'm going to cut it after the last video. So probably did already an introduction. But yours was about chill filtering. Now I'm going to do coloring. I'm not going to do coloring with that.
What was artificial it? Staff.
Artificial thing. I just think that's, well, that's ridiculous. You don't artificial color. End of story. Yeah, so much. But this is about how is whisky maturing and coloring in a cask? And I filled the cask with fresh whisky, as you've seen in the video. And you could look through that cask. That's not a magnetic field. It's a, what do you call it? Plexiglass?
Yeah,
it's some kind of acrylic glass, mm-hmm. Sealed with beeswax. That's the top and the bottom, so you can watch through it. So I'm just going to go over to...
Not top and bottom, the ends, because the cask is lying.
Yeah. Okay. So let's just head over to the cask. You just got to take the glasses with you. So the problem with experiencing and recording the whisky so that you have a common light source is a bit of a problem, because if I would have just let it stay there and film it, then I would have had summer and winter, and you have different kind of light in summer and winter, different kind of darknesses. And so I had to build this cask a little burka, so you have only the artificial light that I put into this concealment. It's LED light, about 12 centimeters, that's 5 inches. Something like five, six inches, behind a diffuser, mm-hmm. but which diffuses the light. So you only have a nice, lightened foreground, so you can see the whiskey through the glass. And what we then did is we cut a little hole in here, so you can actually taste it as well. So are there any questions? Because you are, I don't know, you know about the same as the our viewers.
The cask is made from American wood.
It's American white oak, I think from Minnesota. 220 liters. That's about, I don't know, 54 gallons, 55 gallons, something like that. It has a heavy toast because I wanted to have a good coloring. Toasting is very important for coloring. It has no char and no lids because there's acrylic glass in there.
Yeah, so there are sometimes in Scotland use casks with fresh ends on it, which are then heavily toasted and charred. And so we took a fresh cask, as with a bourbon, and had the ends removed by neutral material, so you can look through.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I had, you know, when I visited Ireland, you had the big screw, and then you had a thing that gave you a lot of inertia, and you could rip out the
bung.
The bung. I removed this before the video, and have the rubber cork from the guy who made the cask for us, because it wouldn't have made any sense without wooden stopper.
Don't drop the pipette.
Yeah, otherwise we have it in the picture for the 10 years.
two of them? No, one is enough, huh?
Well, is nah, let's do two.
One for me, two for you.
Okay, there you go. So, got 1.5. So, enough about the cask. And you can watch this on whiskey.com. I'm gonna set it up in a few days, probably. So, this is the stuff from the German tank. Where's my glass? That's my glass?
Yes.
Okay, it's yours. I thought that was a leftover from the German take, because we did this before in German. So I already had that, the distillery video of the St. Kilian distillery. Don't have any logos here. Will come up in a few days.
Extremely fruity.
And I've already tried it, so I'm really excited what you think about it.
Definitely. A new make.
I can tell you, there's not much difference between a 0 years whiskey and a 1 day whiskey. There's not much going on there.
Astonishingly, very, very few alcohol. So it's really nice and smooth, and the faints are really cut off. So it's a very good middle cut.
Yeah.
So this is the difference between, now say, Scotland or central parts of Europe, where you're allowed to smell the new make and can tell you when do you switch over. In Scotland, they have a table with temperature and alcoholic content or density. And then they say, okay, now temperature and density, this means alcoholic content, ABV, this, and now I switch over to the middle cut. In Germany or in Liechtenstein, I visited the Telsa distillery, and they are smelling. I say, now.
Yeah, the thing is, at the St. Kilian distillery, they had to have a special vent for venting, and it has a clock on it, so you're paying taxes on what you smell. So much for, oh, you can smell it. No, you have to have that special lock with that special thing that counts how much you smell.
Germany, the highest taxed country in the world.
And they have bolts on the pot still everywhere. So everything is bolted, and the tax man is always, bolt is still good, bolt is still good. If the bolt's broken, you have a problem. But there's actually not that much going on here.
No. It's fruitiness.
In the distillery, there was much more going on, but that was because something behind me was fermenting and there was some mashing in the back.
It's a really a quiet, clean new make.
Yeah. Quite clean new make. You got a lot of peers in there. I really want to visit a fruit schnapps distillery where they do peer schnapps. So I really
know,
want to
I
see.
I know one.
You know, yeah.
It's 30 kilometers away, 30 clicks.
Okay, 69.3.
And I should swallow that neat.
Breathe out when you have it in your mouth. And when you think you're done with breathing out, then stop breathing out and then you taste it. If you breathe out, you don't taste anything.
Nothing to do this evening? You're completely paralyzed with your mouth? No. So not for me. So 53 was the maximum I had before. And
okay, yeah,
this is hefty.
Compared to the last one, I had the 43% there as well. It's a bit spicier than that one, but it's very, very, very heavy on the piers.
Yeah,
very heavy
and
on the piers.
There's no sharpness.
Now I have to say, the taste buds, a bit paralyzed, definitely. But
and I'm missing completely the vanilla. I'm missing the caramel, the sweetness.
Yeah, there's nothing.
If you smell just a little bit, then there's a little difference in aroma. If you have some distance to your nose.
So what you got in there?
Honey.
Honey. Mm-hmm. Okay.
You said the lids are fixed with beeswax.
Beeswax, yeah. But that's normal. That's in every whiskey.
Uh-huh.
Beeswax is actually a very, very good sealant. I think they...
Maybe that's beeswax.
I think I had the beeswax at... I'm not quite sure. Probably should go back to watching the video. But I think we had that at Brown-Forman Cooperage. And I think they did it in Japan as well.
Mm-hmm.
There's a video coming up where you see a cask being charred at at Yoichi or Miyagikyo.
Mm-hmm.
Both Nikka. So.
So what you're doing, you're heating up the cask from the inside up to 150 centigrade. That's 280 Fahrenheit probably. And then the cellulosis in the cask breaks up and forms sugar molecules, and those sugar cellulosis is a polysaccharide, and then you have these sugar molecules, and they are then
caramelized
or oxidized to caramel.
Mm-hmm.
And therefrom the dark reddish color comes from, brown reddish color comes from. This cask is only toasted, and when you're going in it with a
blowtorch,
the torch, and fire it up, then it burns. So the toasting goes on for 2 or 3 minutes, and then with a torch you light it up. It's lots of flames for 30 seconds, and then a charcoal layer appears on the inside. And this charcoal layer has two influences on the whiskey. One is the charcoal filters the sharp substances like the faints, which aren't present here. And the second one is that there is a boundary layer between the charcoal and the cask itself, the just oxidized or the caramelized sugars. And in this boundary layer, there are some not fully oxidized to charcoal compounds, and they smell and taste a little bit smoky.
Yeah, but it's very faint. So you have to have either a very old whiskey. Yeah, only with a very old whiskey with a big char, and you're not allowed to have any peat smoke in there. If you have any peat smoke, it's peat smoke.
Yeah,
that's dominant.
Yeah,
but we have an unpeated whiskey, not 0 ppm. It's a single malt.
Zero ppm.
0 ppm.
Yeah.
0 ppm. And we are looking for these caramelized sugars, how they interact with the cask. And what is very important is the whiskey goes into the cask staves and comes back out, and that's what gives it the color. And that is enhanced by temperature differences. So I can probably take my temperature measurement thingy up here and put it next to the cask.
Mm-hmm.
But my temperature is in this studio here is rather constant. Summer can be a bit hot, and then we will cool it down to 24 degrees when we do videos.
Mm-hmm.
with the AC.
If not, we're conserving energy, and then it goes up to 27,
yeah.
30.
Yeah.
So we have the differences in a higher temperature range.
I think we will go up to 30 degrees in here or higher. Mm-hmm. But it will be regularly turned down by videos. Mm-hmm. And I think in the winter we have, I don't know, 15 degrees in here, 15 degrees Celsius. Sorry that we can't translate it all in Fahrenheit because...
Centigrade is already popular.
Popular? Very good. Hopefully. I have never had anybody complaining about that before. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this will be a longer project. Expect more videos where we try the cars in regular intervals of time. And then I will always take a sample. I didn't take a sample because...
We had a fresh sample.
We had a fresh sample and there is no difference. Seriously, there's no difference. I think I see a slight difference in color, but there's not much difference. So, I'm going to calibrate the camera and bring it up on whiskey.com. It's already up on whiskey.de.
Yeah. So we have a gauge, a color scheme on the front of the...
Yeah, I still have to light that.
Yeah, you have to light that. And this will give you, a point where you can have a constant reference on the white or on a gray point. And there are green and reds as well on blue on it, so that we can do a full calibration of the pictures. And with those full calibrations, we have the chance to build a sequence and a time lapse.
And show you how the thing evolved. I think I will do a time lapse every time we try it. At the beginning it will be very short. We'll be just boop and hello on whiskey.com. In the end maybe it will be a bit longer. But science. Let's talk about science. What is science? Science is the scientific method is about checking of results. What do you call that? I'm missing a word here. We're gonna take all the data and make it available to everybody so everybody can check the data. So we have...
This is not very common today. Everybody interprets data.
Yeah. I know. It's not very common today. But I'm gonna promise you we have samples. We will take samples from different time zones so we can have a look at them afterwards and put them in a cupboard where there's no light to have influence on the color, and we will have photos up on the website and we will save them on the server and save them on another server as well, and we have another camera, DSLR camera, that also takes photos, just a bit of backup for us, and then we will make them publicly downloadable so everybody can download these pictures and have a look if we did any mistakes when we do the investigation, how the...
Probably we can spare out the investigation, spare time, and have people...
Yeah, probably even people will do that, but we will do that as well because we're the scientists. But we are open to scrutiny. If someone says, hey, you calibrated it wrong, then please feel free to say so because we want to have this experiment public and we want to make it right.
Yeah.
So, I think enough said, and thank you very much. Keep being subscribed because we will upload more of these videos and you can see the story unfold, how the whiskey gets darker. Thanks for watching.
Take time, 10 years to go.
Yeah, maybe it takes some time. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time.